Hello and welcome to this demonstration of my activity planner. This is built using Microsoft Excel and VBA. This was originally built for a charity to help them manage their fundraising activities. The idea being that all the smaller teams within the fundraising department can put all of their activities in one place and they can see nice and clearly exactly what is coming up and when. I actually based this off a template from the Microsoft website for a homework calendar. So if you're interested in that one, I will also put a link to that in the description. If you'd like a copy of this spreadsheet, then drop me an email. The details are in the description. Please put the subject as Activity Planner Template Request. Okay, let's actually look at the spreadsheet. There are two sheets here. One is the calendar view, and we'll look at that in a bit. And the other is the Activity Planner. The Activity Planner sheet is essentially a list of all the activities added so far. You have this big table here, and this works like any table in Excel. You have the drop downs where you can filter or order by a particular header. So for example, maybe Dan has come into the sheet and he wants to look at the activities he's leading on, and he's interested in the ones that are happening in April and May. And there we have it, the three activities that Dan is working on, and so he now knows what he needs to focus on in the next couple of months. Let me click clear filters just to clear that filtering we've added. Okay, however, if you actually try to enter data into the table, you can't do it directly. So if I click on a row, it highlights that activity. Another example, if I click on telemarketing 2019, it's highlighting multiple rows because that activity spans across a wider date range. So to add a new activity, you have to click this button here, Add New. You will see this form and you just have to fill out the details of your activity. So let's imagine we are doing a festival stall. This is to get people to sign up to our newsletter and also to set up regular gifts. Expected volume doesn't really make sense in this context because it's at a festival and we don't know how many people are going to come to the stall. That's more for a mailing or an email blast. Lead team, let's say it's the community team. Start date, we'll put in the 1st of May 2019. If it's only on one date, you don't need an end date, but let's imagine this is a 2-day festival. Mediums just tells us what type of medium this activity is. You can set multiple ones if you want. However, for this one, I'm just going to click on event. Communication type, event. Lead contact, that's me. I'm not going to enter a comms lead. This was just a request of the charity to add a communications lead to the form as well. Select all relevant segments. This is thinking about the audience. So this charity had a bunch of segments, how they categorized their audience, and we assigned those segments to each activity. That way we can monitor which audiences are receiving which activities at a particular time. You can set multiples and stick them across. However, this one is with people we don't actually know, so it's just going to be the cold segment. Finally, select response handling brief link. This should be a folder or a particular document that outlines the response forms or what action needs to be taken. It might have some background about the activity. So it's basically just the documentation and the planning behind the actual activity. In this case, you can click dot, dot, dot and select a file. But in this case, I'm going to actually just type in a website. Finally, there's a question saying, does this have an ask for a gift? So are we asking for money in this case? Yes, we are. That's just so that we can put in other activities that aren't a direct ask. Click add, click yes, and that's now added the activity to the planner. And what it does is it jumps straight down to that row and selects that activity for you so you can see it really easily after adding. Great, so that's added it here. It's also added it here in the calendar. Let's have a look at editing or copying an activity. So let's find my activity again. There it is, festival stall. If I click edit slash copy, that same form appears, but this time I can make a change anywhere I want and click update existing, and that will amend the existing activity. Or I can click add as new, and that will just make a second copy of this activity. So if you have an activity that is recurring, you can literally go into the existing ones, change the date, make any other adjustments you need to make, and click add as new, and it will create a new activity for you. If I click delete, that will actually remove the activity entirely. So let's click delete. It gives you a little warning saying this will delete the whole activity, not just the row you clicked. So in this case, if I've clicked row 11, it will delete row 11 and row 13 because they are both the festival stall activity. So I click yes, and it's now gone. Expand slash collapse. This button basically auto fits the cells. So you can see here, these cells are actually a lot larger than they appear initially. If I now collapse again, it goes back to a consistent size and I can see more rows on the screen. So let's see that again. Expand, auto fits to the rows, collapse, a more compact view. And finally, there is this add to Outlook calendar button. This allows you to select an activity and click add to Outlook. And what it will do is it'll open up your Outlook calendar and it will populate it with the date, the activity name and description, and then the user can make any changes and click save on that appointment. It won't work here because I'm on my personal computer and I don't have Outlook set up. One more thing to mention here is users can change this as they like, so they can fiddle around, do bits and bobs with sizing of the cells. If they click out and back into the sheet, it will snap back to the original formatting, so it keeps it looking nice and clean. Okay, let's have a look at the calendar sheet now. So it's a simple calendar view. You have these options up here on the top right. So for example, the select month option, I can use these arrows to toggle through the months, or I can use the drop down to jump straight to the month I'm interested in. Similarly, we have a select year. Again, I can toggle back and forth, or I can type it in directly. So I can jump to 2022, or jump back to 2019. The view type, we have two options, simple and detailed. We're currently in simple, and what that means is you can just see the name of the activity in the calendar. If I change it to detailed, you will have a little bit more information. However, again, you can edit the cell size and see the full information. And if you click out and back in, it will snap back to the default settings. You can have up to 8 activities in one day in this version of the calendar. However, if there are fewer than that, it hides those rows, so you only see what is there. The other options you have are these filters. So, filter team, I can select a team, and that way I only see the activities for that team. So here's May, I can see all of the individual giving activity. If I put it back to all, you will see there's other teams activities that appear. Next, you can filter by audience. So earlier I was talking about those segments. In here, you can actually select one of those segments. So let's say we're looking at cash donors active. And this will just show us the activities for that particular segment. So I can see that the cash donors active audience have actually got a telemarketing campaign, they've got this spring appeal reminder, and they've got this e-news going on in 1 month. So we know it's quite busy for them. Let's go back to all. Finally, you've got the medium filter. So I can select the medium email, for example, and that just shows me just the activities that are happening via email. So I can now see here we have an e-reminder for an event, but we also have an e-news 2 days later. So in this situation, we might think, hang on, this is too close. Maybe we need to consider our options. Let's get Tina and Dan to have a meeting and see if they want to combine that email or if they should separate out the people who are receiving the reminder from the e-news. So that's the idea. That's why this spreadsheet exists, is to highlight these clashes and to show us when we might be doing too much or too little. Let me clear all of those. The only other thing to show you in this view, in this calendar sheet, is if you click on an activity, you see that same form that you saw before, and you can edit it as before. You can also add a copy of that activity, or you can delete it, or you can add it to your Outlook calendar. And this is all there, so you don't have to pop back into this sheet, find it in the list. You can just access it directly from the calendar, click on that activity, and you can do any of these different actions. So that concludes the demonstration. I hope you can see this is a useful tool for a fundraising team, and I'm sure there's other applications that this could be used for. If you'd like a blank copy of this spreadsheet, then please drop me an email. The details are in the description. Thanks for watching.